Okay, this is Joe at Plum Crazy Restorations. We're here on the 2007 Jeep. Disassembling the engine due to lack of compression on cylinder number 5. And we found a whole lot of goodies. So let's take a look at what we have here. And we'll start with the number 5 piston. What do we got?
What we have is something got in here and banging around, a number 5 piston. It's also very clean on this piston here. It's like got washed from either fuel or water. And I didn't see any gas in there. It doesn't smell like gas, but it feels like antifreeze, like a little bit of water got in there. But the piston came up, hit the valve. You can see the line where the valve hit. And a piece of it came off, I guess, and banging around inside here.
Yeah.
And it also transferred over into the other side a little bit. See, these ones here are all okay. No problem. The motor doesn't have very many kilometers on it. I could turn it over and you can see there's no play around here.
Yeah, the piston's kind of seized in the cylinder. It's not moving at all, like the rings are just stuck.
See, there's also a difference in color here.
You can see right below the line there, it's rubbing.
These ones here, these pistons, they have a little bit of movement like they should have, where the other one did not. It's like the rings are stuck in the piston.
Right.
And this one here has the proper color it would have. We got a little bit of water there from when we pulled the heads off, but that's just recent.
Okay. And let's look at this one over here. You said we were getting some transfer.
Yeah, I'll bring it up so you can see we get some transfer.
Yeah, I see it right at the top right there.
Yeah, metal transfer from one cylinder over into the other cylinder. It would do that because it's just
it's a very narrow runner on the lower plenum.
So. That's right, it's not an upper and lower plenum straight across, so it will transfer over the other side.
Okay.
I think this is where it came from.
All right, and what do we got up here on the bench?
And here the cylinder heads. As we took them off, this is the passenger side, this is the driver's side, and this is the number 5 cylinder, and this is what we found. It's got a bent valve. You can see damage right in here.
Okay.
And the light down here, you can see obviously there's a bent valve going on there, lots of light. Where the other ones don't do that, it's absolutely nothing.
Right.
And it transferred over onto this side. You can see it's actual divot marks in the cylinder head. So something transferred from one side to the other side.
Yeah.
Okay. This side seems to be okay there.
And the valves are not bent on that side.
No, and what I found also, it has a bent push rod also.
Yeah.
Put a flat surface and rolled it. And this one here is actually quite bent compared to.
Let's actually do this.
And roll it. And it's quite bent.
Yeah,
it's
pretty bad.
And also what I found is rocker shaft assembly here. The rockers, they move quite freely when they're supposed to. This one here is stuck. So I don't know what happened here, whether this failed or something else failed. And the runners here are also very clean. This is the runner on number 5. It's very clean. Like it got washed with water. It's absolutely very clean, spotless clean.
Okay.
And this other one over here is normal. It's a little bit of debris, a little bit of staining. And same thing, all the rest of them are all normal.
Okay.
So I had to check for, obviously you can see that there's a good seal all the way around. So
yeah, let me get that in the picture. We can get a shot of that. Yeah, you can see the line where the gasket actually sealed properly.
Absolutely. So it's been sealing very well all the way around, all of them. There's nothing transferring past the gasket.
Okay.
Even on the head gasket surface
double check
also.
This side. Yeah, you can see the seal everywhere.
Yeah, it's fine. There's nothing wrong with the gasket seal.
Okay. And the head gaskets?
And the head gaskets were fine. Nothing wrong with them.
Okay, they weren't blowing. That was
not blowing out on the sides or anything. They're not coming transferring from cylinder to cylinder. Nothing from cylinder to a water jacket anywhere. And you can also see the same sealing marks on the heads themselves.
Yeah.
There's nothing wrong with them there. It's all sealing up fine. So it leads me to believe something else happened.
Yeah, with the cylinder being this clean, it almost looks like there was coolant or something going in and washing it out.
Something was in there washing, that's for sure. It was either fuel or gas or water, one or the other. There's nothing else left in the motor.
Definitely took off the carbon.
Yeah, washed it off real clean. And it didn't take long.
Okay, well, we'll put this
package
to the customer and put it on hold until we figure out the next move, what they want to do.
Okay.
Okay, sounds good. Thanks.
Okay.